With many of the popular protest movements that began in 2019 still going strong in 2020, journalists are frequently caught in the middle of the action.
These protests have been continuing over the course of the past few months, and authorities have not stopped targeting journalists.
We have also seen journalists routinely being harassed, being attacked, being beaten, detained while covering the protests, being attacked with tear gas, with batons, and we're seeing this around the world.
CPJ continues to monitor and respond to situations where reporters and photographers find themselves in harm's way.
Journalists have definitely come under threat as they've been reporting on these protests. Journalists have been attacked by police, they've had their equipment confiscated, and CPJ has also documented a number of journalists who've been detained.
Cuando cubrimos este tipo de historias, cuando cubrimos este tipo de protestas, somos conscientes que a veces nos pueden pegar y a veces nos pueden confundir con manifestantes, pero no debería ser la dinámica.
Diego Ibarra Sanchez, a Spanish photojournalist, has been harmed several times while covering demonstrations in Beirut, including being struck by a rubber bullet.
Me han pegado la policía con un bastón de hierro en la espalda. Me han pegado partidarios de un grupo político, bofetón en toda la cabeza. Y el último incidente que tuve fue que fui alcanzado por una pelota no reglamentada de goma lanzada por la policía. Estaba sacando fotografías, estaba justo en lo que sería en el sitio más cercano entre la primera línea que separa los manifestantes más violentos de la policía antidisturbios, lo que se podría decir esa front line, estaba el primero de todos y fui alcanzado por una pelota.
Photographers have to be on the front lines. They really have to be in the midst of the action in order to shoot what's happening. CPJ has systematically documented the aggression against photographers, again, around the world covering protests. Aggression is coming both from the side of authorities, of police, who are beating them, who have detained them, but also photographers have been beaten by protesters themselves.
Many of the frontline journalists bear the brunt of these police action and also protester actions.
Jennifer Creary has covered the popular protests in Hong Kong since they began in June 2019.
Particularly at the beginning of the protests, when journalists were given kind of very minimal gear, so kind of basic gas masks, that kind of stuff, certainly a lot of reporters got injured.
Journalists using bandanas to protect against tear gas, against gas, it's not enough. Depending on the risk level that they think they're going to encounter, journalists should go out to cover protests with the appropriate personal protective equipment.
We've learned to kind of upgrade our gear as the protests have gone on. So, of course, we have helmets, gas masks, full face gas masks, protective eyewear. Hong Kong Free Press journalists have all experienced some kind of injury, whether that be, you know, being pepper sprayed, hit with projectiles, tear gas, stuff like that.
Every journalist, every reporter, every photographer should conduct a proper risk assessment before going out to cover a situation that could in any way be dangerous or turn violent. Journalists covering particularly violent situations really should have training, ideally hostile environment training, certainly they should have first aid training.
Yo voy completamente documentado, carnet de prensa internacional, un casco donde tengo también la palabra escrita de prensa en inglés.
CPJ is going to continue to issue safety advice as protests are happening to be able to allow journalists to properly prepare to go out and cover those stories.
Conozco los riesgos de trabajar sobre el terreno. Lo que no puedo entender ni jamás podré entender que se nos tome como enemigos a la prensa, porque solo somos comunicadores. Solo somos unas herramientas para mostrar lo que está pasando.